Welcome to the Spy Collection. I am Anastasios and in this episode we'll have a look at the Vega family of sub-miniature cameras from the Soviet Union that also have a unique spy history. In 1955, the Japanese Minolta introduced the Minolta 16, a quite innovative 16mm sub-miniature camera for that era. Seeing that, the Soviet camera and lens manufacturer Arsenal decide to reverse engineer it and produce the Kiev Vega. It was so identical that it was even compatible with the Minolta film cassettes. Eventually, Kiev Vega was introduced to the market in the late 1950s and it continued to be produced until 1961 to 1962. Inside each package, we have the empty cassette holder that the owner could easily load its 16mm film. A couple of film rolls. And a leather pouch with a camera. Inside the pouch we'll also find two more filters. Those filters can be placed here. As you can see, it's a very small camera. On the side we have the aperture and shutter speed settings. And on the bottom, the counter for the exposures. To operate it, you pull it and then you use the shutter release button here to take a photo. This is the viewfinder. And here you see the shutter. You repeat the process to take more photos. This movement is also what rotates the film internally. And here you can read that this camera was equipped with the Industar M f3.5 23mm lens. And by pressing this button here, you can open it. This is the outer case, and this is the main body of the camera. Here is where the film is located. So when you press the shutter release, it opens over here and exposes the film for the pre-configured time. We mentioned that Kiev Vega was only manufactured from the late 50s to 1961 to 1962. And that's because in around that time, 1961 to 62, Arsenal started producing the Vega 2. This one. This is its manual and you can find a scanned copy of it in the description of the video if you'd like to study it. This camera had a few upgrades, including this wheel to help you identify the best settings based on the photo you wanted to take. This isn't changing anything on the camera settings, just helping the operator identify the optimal settings and then use the same knobs to configure it. This one also had a proprietary cassette incompatible with the Kiev Vega. In addition to that, here is the body of Vega, and here is the body of Vega 2. As you see here, it had this focus control, which could be set from 0.5 meters all the way to infinity. It's also worth noting that the export version of those cameras had their logo written using the Latin alphabet rather than the Cyrillic that you see here. But how do all of that relate to espionage? Remember that those were produced by Arsenal, which was based in Kiev during the Soviet Union era. The KGB had headquarters in all of its member states, in this case Ukraine, although the main headquarters were based in Moscow. Knowing that, let's read a small snippet from the 2018 book, The Secret History of KGB Spy Cameras. The Soviet sub-miniature Vega 2 was manufactured commercially at the Kiev Arsenal factory in 1961 to 1964. A version of the camera, camouflaged as a cigarette pack, was produced for the counterintelligence service of the Ukrainian KGB. The Vega 2 camera is a functional copy of the Minolta 16. The camera used 60mm non-perforated or perforated film with a cassette capacity of 30 images. The image size was 10 by 14 millimeters. The camera body was produced from aluminium and consisted of a removable outer casing and an inner light-tight casing that housed the lens, shutter mechanism, and film advance. And here is a photo from that book that shows this modified Vega 2 with a description. The cigarette pack camouflage concealed the camera. The example shown here was printed in the Ukrainian language and was produced in 1972. Actually, in the spy collection, we have two such modified cameras from the counterintelligence service of the Ukrainian regional KGB office. This is from 1975. And here is how the modified mechanism works. Do you see this worn spot over here? That's because this is where the shutter release button is located. You're pressing here to cycle the film. Some operators were even placing real cigarettes to make it more of an active concealment device. And here are the holes for the camera lens. Now if we open this up, you see that it's a very simple spring-loaded mechanism. And here is another version of it, also from 1975, but this time from Moscow. It has the same punched holes for the camera lens and exactly the same operating mechanism. Although this one is also from 1975, it had a slight modification. To avoid damaging the packaging, like you see here, in this case, the KGB technicians glued a small piece of cardboard on the shutter release button. And that was the Soviet Arsenal Kiev Vega and Vega 2 along with his secret espionage history in the hands of the KGB. Those modified cameras were very widely used from training all the way to real counterintelligence operations during the Cold War era, but nowadays it's becoming almost impossible to find them. If you do find such items, please reach out to us, as we are always interested in expanding the spy collection and document as many espionage objects as possible for historical purposes. Before closing this, you have to remember that smoking during the Cold War era was so popular and accepted everywhere, in public transportation, work, airplanes, and anywhere else you can imagine. It was perfectly normal for anyone to be carrying around a pack of cigarettes, having it in their hands or on their table, or just fiddling with it while walking. It wouldn't raise any suspicions, and because of that, those concealed KGB spy cameras are a great example that nothing is as it seems.